Okay guys, let's do some practice questions on data handling or statistics. So this is the question. The weight in kilograms of the Springbok rugby players are? So you have 15 Springbok rugby players. So the first question is to determine the mean weight of the players. The mean is equal to the sum of the values in the data set over the number of the values in the data set. So you can use this formula to find the mean weight of the players, or you just have to use a calculator, which will be quick. Okay, let's use a calculator. What is the mean equal to? Let's get our calculator. So you can see if you have to use the formula, it will be a long process. You have to take the sum of the values and then you divide by the number of the values in the data set, which is over 15. But we are going to use a calculator. So the calculator is going to do the job for us. Okay, to find the mean using the calculator, you start by pressing mode. There is mode. And then you go to start, which is option 3. So you choose 3 and then you choose 1 minus var, which is option 1. And then now you can insert the values that you have. You insert all these values. So you make sure you don't leave any value behind. So we start with 90. And then you press equal to insert it. And then you have 101. So make sure you don't leave any value. And then you have 92. And then you have 89. And then you have 108. And then you have 78. So it doesn't matter if the values are arranged in ascending order or descending order. All you have to do is to insert all the values without leaving any value behind. So the next value is 85. And then 106. And then 93, and then 78, and then 105. Make sure you insert all the values, and then 106, and then 112, and then 88, and then 112. Okay, so you have inserted all the values. Now what you want to do is to press SC, there is SC, and then you go and press shift, and then you press start, which is above 1, and then you choose var, which is option 4, and then you can see there is the mean, which is option 2. You can see x bar, which is the mean. X bar is the mean. So you choose option 2 to get the mean, and then you press equal. So the mean is equal to 96.2. So 96.2 kilogram. You remember the units are kilogram. So this is the mean weight of the players. And now the next question is to find the standard deviation of the weight of the players. So this is the formula for finding the standard deviation, which is this one. You can use this formula to find the standard deviation of the weight of the players. And using this formula, the process will be very long. So the calculator can do the job for us. Okay, let's use the calculator to find the standard deviation of the weight of the players. Now, since the information is still in the memory of the calculator, you can see you have start there. It means that the information is still in the memory of the calculator. So these values are still in the memory of the calculator. All you have to do is to press SC, and then you go and press shift, and then you press start, which is above 1. So you choose option 1, and then you choose var, which is option 4. And then now you can find the standard deviation. You can see the standard deviation is option 3. Can you see? So you choose option 3, you press 3, and then you press equal. So this is the standard deviation, which is 11.27 to 2 decimal places. So the standard deviation is 11.27. You can see how the calculator is making things easy for us. Now the next question, what percentage of players lies within one standard deviation of the mean. So you need to find the percentage of players lying within one standard deviation of the mean. We have to get the values around the mean. Okay, so the mean is 96.2. We found it in question 1. So let's put down the mean, 96.2. This is the mean. Now to find the values lying within one standard deviation of the mean, you have to go above the mean and below the mean by one standard deviation. So when you go above the mean, what you do is to add 11.27. So 11.27 is our standard deviation. You can see we got it from question 2. So you take 96.2 plus the standard deviation to go above the mean. And this gives you, what do you get? Let's use our calculator again. So you have 96.2 plus 11.27, and this is equal to 107.47. 107.47. So you have gone one standard deviation above the mean. And now you have to go again one standard deviation below the mean. So what we have to do is to minus. So you take 96.2 minus 11.27. Let's use our calculator again. So you have 96.2 minus 11.27. This gives you 84.93. Can see? So it gives you 84.93. So now you now have an interval around the mean. So now this interval, using these values, 84.93 and 107.47, will tell you which players lies within one standard deviation of the mean. Now let's see which players lies within one standard deviation of the mean. To see that, you have to get these values first in order. You have to put them in ascending order, meaning from smallest to the biggest. So you start with the smallest, which is 78, you can see. So 78, and then you have another 78. So you put all the values down, you write them in ascending order so that you don't make a mistake. You have to check for values lying within this interval. Okay, so now you can see 78 doesn't lie within this interval because it is less than 84.93. You can see it is out of this interval. So the 78 are not included in this interval. They are out of the interval. 85 is included. You can see it's greater than 84.93, but less than this value. You can see 85 is included. All these values are included in the interval up to 106. You can see 108 is out. You can see it's greater than this value. So this and this and this are not included in the interval. So you only have how many players that are included in this interval? You have this one. Let's count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10 out of 15. There are 15. So 10 out of 15, only 10 are included in this interval. So we need to calculate what? The percentage of players lying within one standard deviation of the mean. You only find that only 10 players out of 15 players lie within this interval, only 10. So you do 10 over 15 times 100 to get the percentage. And this is equal to, let's get our calculator to find the percentage. So you have 10 over 15 times 100. And this gives you 66.67, if you can round it off to two decimal places. So this is 66.67 percentage. Okay, now question 4. Draw a box and whisker diagram for the data. We need to draw a box and whisker diagram for the data. So this is the number line. You have it. So to draw a box and whisker diagram for the data, you need the minimum value, which is 78. Let's get 78 on the number line. Where is 78? This is 75, 76, 77, 78. So 78 is there, you can see. So we put a dot there. And then you need a maximum value, which is 112. Where is 112? There is 110. There is 111 and there is 112. So you put a dot on 112. There is 112. Okay. And then now you need the median. The median is the middle value. You can see you have 15 values here. So the middle value will be somewhere there because you have 7 values there and 7 values there. Can you count them? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And you can see you also have 7 values this side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 93 is the median. So 93 is the median. Where is 93 on the number line? There is 95. So this is 94 and this is 93. 93 is there, can you see? So you put a vertical line on 93. There is 93 there. And now you need the lower quartile, which is Q1. So the lower quartile will be the middle value of the 7 values here. You have these 7 values there in the lower part. So the middle value will be 88. Can you see? You have 3 values there and 3 values this side. So 88 is in the middle. So where is the lower quartile, which is also Q1? You can see this is 90, this is 89, and this is 88. So the lower quartile, Q1, is there. So you put a vertical line there. And now you need an upper quartile, which is Q3. So an upper quartile will be the middle value of these 7 values. You can see these 7 values. So it will be 1, 2, 3. This is the middle one. 1, 2, 3. You can see 106 is in the middle. So this is the upper quartile, which is Q3. So where is 106? This is 105. There is 106. You can see there. So you put a vertical line there. Can see it. And now this is all you need to draw a box and whisker diagram. Now what we have to do is to join the box. So you join the box there, and then you join there, and then you join your minimum value to the box there, and then you also join the maximum value to the box there. So this is the box and whisker diagram for the data. Okay, I hope this video was helpful. If you find some value in this video, don't forget to subscribe and activate the notification bell so that you can be notified every time I post new content for you. You can see down below is my name and the email address at which you can contact us. If you have any question or anything that you would like to let us know, feel free to use the email address down below. As for now, see you next time and take care.